said, like, he doesn't let people talk about me. He doesn't say things about me. Blah, 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 blah. He's not my enemy. Blah, blah, blah. Well, I thought we had resolved the glasses issue because I told you, Brian, I like your glasses. I like nerdy glasses. It's a compliment. I was just saying a fucking joke in a fucking chat. Which.
Right. But what you said before that was, please keep me out of you and your friends' drama. And I said, okay. I'll show the text that happened before you made the joke. I said, okay, I won't talk about you. And I don't talk about you, right? And then you left a comment about my Christianity. That these glasses make me look more Christian. I care less about the glasses part of it. They're Versace's. It was about the faith part of it. And I called you and I said, you're mean. And she goes, what do you mean I'm mean? I said, why are you going to make jokes about my glasses and my Christianity? She's leaving the Christianity part out of it so far. Right? And the reason that she got mad was because she was talking to me on the phone and shoot the shit. She goes, oh my God, now shoot the shit's over there dragging me, and hung up on me. That's why she hung up on me.
John, I was going to say, this is the reason, like, I don't even like going to chats anymore. Because I know my shit is going to get screenshot. Why can't I make stupid jokes?
If you ask someone to leave you out of their conversation, and then that someone that you ask to leave you out of their conversation, you make a comment about them, you're not going on what you asked that person to do in the first place. They were having a bash fest on me over there at Sarah's, and you joined right on in. That's what the phone call was about.
That have any effect on you? That is very mild in comparison of the things that I've heard come out of Brian's mouth.
Not about you, though. See, you asked me to leave you out of it, and I have.
He does these passive aggressive things, and then when you respond at all, he like makes a video, comments everywhere, boohoos for 20 days. Brian, dude, stop, please. Like, nobody's interested in fighting with you. You won't
like
stop.
I really thought he was calling me for something, like, you know, that I might need to know, because, you know, they're crawling all over people's family trees and shit.
Oh no. See, last time I texted you about something you really might need to know. About you possibly showing you where you lived at. And I texted you about it. That was creepy. Remember? When I privately texted you and said, hey, that you left that sign in there. And then I showed you where your address was. And I showed you how far it could go by looking into Zillow and teasing you about the inside of your house. That was between me and you. It wasn't between me and the community. And you took that over to BTS. Well, you edited that video, and I was talking to you about this in that phone call, too. You edited that video to take the sign out, and you moved it over to the left a little bit when you moved it, right? At first, you had your tags blurred out to your car, right? But then BTS did a live, which is now taken down, and it had a clip in it where you edited it and moved it a little bit, and when you pulled up, you could see your tags. So I emailed BTS, and I said, hey, you might want to take a look at that live, because now when she pulls up, you can see the plate number on her truck. And BTS said, oh, okay, I'll take a look at that. And I guess, I don't know if she edited it or not, but I said, you know, I was telling BTS, she doesn't want to be doxxed, so I thought you would want to take a look at that. So BTS never even told you about that. We talked about that on the phone, too. I was just looking out for you. I don't care if you do. If you do something that could potentially cause you to get doxxed again, you think I'm going to call you or text you again? No, that's on you. That's on you. I was just trying to look out for you. You turn around and wait and say, oh, that's creepy. That's me talking to Hello Starlight.
I answer the phone, this motherfucker is griping about fucking glasses.
Real. I wasn't griping. We were joking about it. I said, you're mean. Why would you do that for? I wasn't griping at you, and I'm not a motherfucker either.
Really? Really?
Yeah, he's so, that's like the least of the things going on around here. I'm just reminding everybody that
I had people over in another chat, which I'm just going to go ahead and say something about that. Hey, Miss Nomer, thank you for joining the membership.
Welcome.
Welcome to the rebellion. Anyways, so shit, what was I saying? Because I was going off on
another. Okay, you're talking about how he's upset about the glasses. You thought you were about the glasses.
I wasn't upset about the glasses. I was upset about the comment about my faith, and that's exactly what we were talking about in the phone call. I was joking with her about the glasses, the thing with the faith. These make me look more Christian. And look at this idiot in the chat. Glasses lives matter. There, are you happy now, Brian? Good Lord. That's taking the Lord's name in vain when you say good Lord, by the way.
I lost it. Okay, so basically, Brian, we went back. You won't stop. We went back and forth. I thought things had calmed down. And you hold on to everything Starlight has. Nobody over here does that to you. I don't care what you talk about with your boomer friends. I don't care. I'm just saying.
I don't watch the panels that he even goes on. I don't know.
Me neither.
The reason I'm even talking about it, I'm talking about it publicly, is because of what he did today. And that I also want this to be like a PSA. All the people in the comment section of that video can go fuck themselves. Okay? I don't care and I don't want anything to do with them. They are free to unsubscribe from my channel and go about their merry way. Because I don't insert myself in your fucking boomer drama. So why do you have to come over here when I'm trying to mind my own business? I'm over here doing my best. I'm trying to mind my own business. I even put out a video today with some funny animal clips on it. And that shit is funny. Why don't you watch it and laugh? Give that a try. Try to fucking laugh. Weirdos.
Dude, they act like laughing is such a crime around here. If you laugh, oh my God, you are not allowed to laugh. Or you are a mean girl.
Okay. Hello, Starlight. You're not being completely honest about this phone call. And you're also not being completely honest about the text that you sent me. You tell me to leave you alone, but then you continuously text me. And you text me about the... I asked those people not to make mean comments about you, and you texted me every single comment that they made that were mean. I'm not responsible for their comments. I'm not. I tried. But you're not being honest. And you know it. You're not being honest. We talked about way more in that phone call. And the reason you hung up on me is because the shit was talking shit about you. There goes your hillbilly friends talking about me. Well, maybe they were just making a joke. Right? And you hung up because of that, not because of me. And you know it. Now, if you don't want me, if you ask me to leave you out of my conversations, then you shouldn't go in and make jokes about people. And I called you on a funny note. I was laughing at you and with you. We were laughing there for a minute until shooting shit went live.
I never want to be part of a community like that. So y'all take your shit over there. We don't come over there. Look,
there's obviously a divide going on. Some people, it's sad to see that they want to turn a certain way, but everyone's feelings are valid. And my feelings are valid that I don't want anything to do with you people over there that have to bring, you know, quit bringing Randy into shit and Wendy too.
If Randy and Wendy would quit talking about things, then nobody would have a retort.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, leave them alone. Like, what the fuck? They don't. You guys are seriously.
We're over here, legit.
Now, right here, hang on here. Check this out. I'm gonna show you something. I want to show you something here real quick. Ash274 says, my question, Brian, how long did you search for that shitastic, sappy, crybaby song you used? Right in the video where I put up the clip of Hello Starlight making those comments. It was actually the video that's in my, when you come to my channel, that's the song that they're playing as Jesus is being whipped and crucified. It's a Christian song. But here, let me show you. There's that sappy song, that sappy, shitty song, Ash. There it is. It's about the death of Jesus, and it's on my, when you come to my channel, that's what's playing. It just happened to be playing. I didn't search for it. But there's that sappy song right there, Ash274. Pretty sappy, huh? That shitty song. God forgive you, girl.